Hey guys, my name is Dave and welcome to another video. So today, originally the channel was planning on talking about something else, but today I kind of wanted to talk about something that came to my mind that I've been noticing in individuals a lot recently. So get ready for a little bit of a kind of a tangent, but not, I guess. So recently, I've noticed in a lot of people that, well, not just recently, pretty much for the past 10, 15 years, I've noticed in a lot of people that individuals have a tendency to, when they start to go into a panic or they're in a rush and they're infuriated, or as I said, in a panic from that, they'll start to question things. But the questions they ask aren't particularly what they mean. Now, many of you have probably heard of these situations before. A good example of this is, say somebody's in a hurry to get to work or school. And, well, let's go with school. And they can't find one of their binders that they absolutely need for one of their classes. Nowhere to be found. Search high, low, nothing. So the teenager turns to their parents and goes, "What have you done with it?" However, does the teenager mean this? I mean, yes, but no. This is a prime example of kind of what I'm talking about, one that I saw a lot. The reason I'm using school for it is it's the most frequent one that I've noticed. Now, parents aren't exactly the always the other side. Sometimes it's a roommate if it's a college class, which actually that one I've seen more often than parents for high schools and stuff like that. But still, the thing that I've noticed is that people will go and say, "What did you do with it?" even if the someone had nothing to do with it. Now, I've experienced this myself on many individual cases before. I've been on both sides. I'm guilty of doing this kind of thing. But the thing is, this is more kind of a psychological thing that usually happens when somebody goes into a panic and they don't know what else to do. They'll try to convince themselves that someone else did it until they've realized or seen reason for them doing it. I have fallen prey to this kind of action from myself several a time. I don't know. I have a couple of different things where this kind of came from, but it came to my mind, it came to my attention that it might be something that might be interesting to address. Now, why does this happen? Well, for one, and this is, keep in mind, everything I'm about to say is completely observation. It's not particularly direct fact from like a psychologist or anything like that. This is based, what I'm about to say is based 100% off of observation of individuals from my past. Let's just say I'm glad I kept a binder and random journal entries that were scattered across years and dates. By the time this is uploaded, the journal entries I'm probably talking about would be gone because it's on here. So, that being said, let's get to it. This was back in high school, early years of high school at that. And one of my friends in the friend group that I had, they had lost something of theirs. I was in the same class as this friend as well. If I remember correctly, it was an English class. Not a math. One or the other. Either way around, this individual had completely lost this item that I'm referring, an item that was kind of detrimental. And they decided to, since I was always kind of working with them with like assignments, I was always like partnering with them to study and stuff like that. Even though studying was never really my thing, it didn't happen often. But regardless, because of this, they turned to me at a point and went, "What did you do with this?" I was like, the first response my brain went to is, "Nothing. I've been focused on my stuff." And this individual, they didn't exactly deny what I said, but they didn't exactly confirm it either. They didn't apologize saying, "Oh, sorry, I didn't mean to say that. I'm just freaking out." Neither did they go, "You're wrong," kind of thing. They just kind of went dead silent. Maybe a little, at most. Quite frankly, that one I actually can't remember. The details in the entry that I had written were very vague, but detailed enough to where what I just said kind of clarifies like what that kind of stuff was in there. But regardless, this is kind of the example I'm talking about. This kind of stuff is never intentional, but whenever someone goes into a panic, since that grasp at pinning someone else eases the mind on that kind of thing, that can be something that they could do sometimes, which I can understand. I get it. As I said earlier, I've been there. I've come prey to that kind of action, being one of the ones who have done that action. So I wouldn't exactly have room to say anybody's in the wrong for this kind of thing. However, does it make it right? Well, no, but it doesn't make it wrong either. It's one of those things where it's like instinct makes you do one thing until you realize it was one specific other thing, or if you were actually right. And this happens a lot. Regardless, this is just something that kind of came to my mind. I don't know. What are your guys' thoughts on stuff like this? Have you guys ever experienced something like that before? Whether from one end or the other? Let me know in the comments below. Want to check out any other discussion rant type videos that I've done on this channel? Or if anybody else has done any. I don't think anyone else has done any yet, but why not click the link on the side of my head for that, or the other side will give you just a video that YouTube thinks you might like on here. Anyways, I'm going to head off. Thanks again for watching this video, everyone. I hope to see all of you in another. See you guys later.